Hey, welcome back to Roll With It. Today we're going to deal with a question from Tanner Carson at Raised in Baseball. Came up with some great questions, and one of them that we're going to deal with today is, let's say you happen to try out for a team and you get cut. And it can happen to anybody at any different level. Today I got a special guest here in the car. I got Steve Bernhardt, somebody who played at a high level at the University of Richmond, also played professionally in the Rockies organization. But there was a time where Steve was cut from his high school baseball team. I think it was your freshman year. And Steve's got some great advice today to tell people how to deal with that in case you are cut.
Well, Steve, thanks for having me. Cool, I've enjoyed watching it. It's nice to be here with you. this question really does hit home, because I still get, to this day, I still get a little bit of an uneasy feeling thinking about it. Walking into Delaney High School as a freshman, looking at that list on the bulletin board outside the gymnasium of who was supposed to report to practice that afternoon for the JV, and not having my name on that list. I must have checked it 10 times thinking I missed it somewhere, scanning it. It was a bad feeling in your stomach. It certainly was. You know, I'm not going to lie, there's a bit of embarrassment that does go along with it, because you played this game for years growing up, and a lot of the guys who are on that roster are guys that you played with, travel ball, rec ball, that kind of stuff. But it can be pretty motivational. You know, you can turn it into a positive.
Yep.
At that young age, when I look back now, one thing I am proud of, I didn't blame anybody. Yeah. I didn't blame the coach. It wasn't his fault. I didn't, you know, spend a lot of time whining about it. I didn't go to administration. I didn't transfer schools. I didn't do any of that. You know what I did? I got back to work and got better.
Yeah. And let me ask you this, because, you know, even your road to get to professional baseball, you're a heck of a college player, went undrafted, ended up signing as a free agent. Do you think having some of that adversity at a younger time in your life helped to propel you to be able to reach deep down and work harder and harder to get signed as a free agent?
I do. I think it helped, because it taught me early on that in really in anything in life, but in this instance, in the game of baseball, you have to constantly prove yourself. You're not given anything. You've got to earn your way onto a team. You've got to earn playing time. You know, I had to make it in high school. Then the next year, I had to make it to the varsity level. I walked on in college, so I had to prove myself there. I went undrafted and got an invite to a spring training. I had to go out and prove myself to the Rockies that I belonged in professional baseball. So it happens with everybody. Even guys right now who are, you know, high school players that are quote-unquote famous or Under Armour All-Americans, you know, they go to college and they've got to prove themselves and work their way into a lineup. If they get drafted, they have to work their way to the big leagues and prove they can play. It really doesn't stop. And for me, it was eye-opening, and it did teach me at a young age, you know what, every time you get on the field, you've got to show everybody around what you can do. You can't take it for granted.